I'm holding on to many things past, to anything that's gonna change my memories back. I'm holding on to everyone good, to everything that's ever been the way that it should. I'm holding on to things you said before you forgot what this love really meant to you. The words that I sent to you, now forgotten to you. No matter how hard I try, try.
Welcome everybody. From Arizona, I just arrived in Qatar. Arabian Insider headed to Qatar for the Qatar International Arabian Horse Show that will be going on in these days at Al Shakaab Stadium. Doha accommodates a lot of beautiful places. One of these is the Educational Center, a center dedicated to research and studies. The Per Qatar, the Aspire Zone, that is a zone in the city just devoted to the sport. The Souk, and a lot of other beautiful places that we will bring you in the next days. But now, let's be concentrated to the show. I just arrived at Al Shakaab Stadium in front of the outside arena that hosted just a few days ago the key Al Shakaab dressage and jumping event. The 26th edition of the Qatar International Arabian Horse Show, proudly organized by the Racing and Equestrian Club, will start tomorrow at 1:30 p.m. And we will see a lot of beautiful horses. We have an amount of 300 horses that will be compete here in the next days. And tomorrow we will start with the yearling filly classy of 2 and 3 years old. So we are really looking forward to see how these classes will go. And we will be the first and second one that will compete in the championship. This is the second year that the Qatar International Arabian Horse Show is seated here in the inside arena of the stadium of Al Shakaab Stadium. Al Shakaab Stadium was founded in 1992 by Sheikh Ahmad bin Khalifa Ali Al Thani, and in 2004 became a member of the Qatar Foundation. That was a really, really important goal for Al Shakaab Stadium. The mission of Al Shakaab Stadium is to promote the highest quality of shows and breeding of Arabian horse show. And for sure to give also competitive opportunities in all the equestrian art.
First things first, I'm the realest.
Realest.
Drop this and let the whole world feel it.
Let them feel it.
And I'm still in the murder business. I can hold you down like I'm giving lessons in physics.
Right, right.
You should want a bad bitch like this.
Huh?
Drop it low and pick it up just like this.
Yeah.
Cup of Ace, cup of Goose, cup of Chris. High heels, something worth a half a ticket on my wrist.
On my wrist.
Taking all the liquor straight. Never chase that.
Never.
Stop like we bring an 88 back.
What?
Bring the hooks in where the bass at. Champagne spilling, you should taste that.
You knew that I'd be the I-G-G-Y. Put my name in ball. I've been working, I'm up in here with some change to throw.
I'm so fancy. You already know I'm in the fast lane. From LA to Tokyo. I'm so fancy. Can't you taste this gold? Remember my name. Hope to blow. Trash the hotel.
Like you just watched in the video, a lot of people is already working for the show that will start tomorrow on Friday. And the tension is really high. For sure, everybody is just looking forward to see the result of this really important show. The contenders are around 300 horses, and for sure they are not only from Qatar, but they come from all around Europe and especially Middle East. But the program of the show will start tomorrow with the yearling filly 2 and 3 years old, and then will continue on Saturday with the yearling colt and mare classes. But this is not just halter, because on Sunday we will for sure have the championship, but at the beginning of the day we will also have the reading class. So this will really be a nice and full weekend of Arabian horses. And today I was so lucky that I had the opportunity to speak a bit with some judges that will attend the show in the next days. So let's have a look at what they think about. Downtown we let it go, sunset high and our bodies low, blood rush in a hazy glow, my hands, your bones, loose up, we break the scene, one step deep as you fall to me, hot clap, we skip a beat, count 1, 2, 3. Thank you so much for your time. I'm sure you are happy to be here like me. And for me, this is my second time in Qatar. First time I just came here, I was really surprised and I just fall in love for this place and especially for Rashid Kafstad. Which was your first time in Qatar?
Yeah, mine was, I think if I remember well, it was in 2006. It's actually 11 years ago right now. And I'm visiting Qatar regularly now, every year, and every year there is something new. So Qatar is practically changing in front of our eyes, so it's an amazing country. So I can just recommend everybody to visit it here.
Me also, I think the first time it was in the beginning of 2004 or 2003. Every year we have statement that there is something changing. Even Arabian horse world or in the environment in general of the country, like all the area in the Gulf, they changed a lot. And we are very happy to show that the quality of breeding in Qatar also growing as the other. It's the same synergy, the same dynamic in the Arab country. And we believe that it will be an important event to stay in Qatar in this year and the next years.
I remember for the first time, before I visited Qatar, I have heard a lot about Al Rayyan's farm. And I think that's a legendary stud farm,
yes,
which is now transferred slowly to Al Shakab, which is I think also good because it was saved from the past. But I was very, very curious for the first time to visit this stud farm and see those amazing horses. And practically I got a chance to visit it just shortly. But it was experience for my whole life,
yes,
because I have seen incredible horses and I actually fall in love immediately into Ashal Al Rayyan and his offspring. So for me this is a hard, let's say, taking issue for me. And I'm actually having also a granddaughter of Ashal in my breeding, so for me it was also somehow beginning of something new. And I'm very happy that I got this chance.
For sure, I think Al Rayyan, one of the big collection in the world.
There is some magic which has to be hidden there, because I don't know how they just could result. For sure, it's a good knowledge and experience of Sheikh Abdulaziz, and also Bart van Wogenhout, who was working for Al Rayyan for a very long time. But I have to just take my head off, because what they did with straight Egyptian horses here, it's just amazing.
And I would like also to speak about some universal content. What do you think about the well-being of the handlers in our work?
I had a lot of bad experience, but you know, we have to talk maybe the responsible of a cow can talk about it. But every stud farm have to put his own security for his staff. Even the judge my chairman, need to be secure in inside arena, of course.
Absolutely, and ECAO is taking care, or at least is involved in a, let's say, partly in this item. For sure, ECAO was established to mainly take care for the welfare of the horses. But we don't have to, we can't forget that the handlers are really a main part of our business. So for sure, their security is mainly in their hands. But we can also somehow support them with our regulations, with our, let's say, advices, and we can lead them somehow in the arenas. Because also our security depends also on them in the arena, as the judges, I mean. And we all know that a good horse is a horse which is mentally and physically balanced.
Good, balancing them.
And that's the work of the handlers. That's why I told you it's in their hands. So they are those who are working with animals. They are training them, they are treating them. And I think most of them, they know that the horse should have for what the horse was bred. And especially Arabian horse is very sensitive breed. So they don't like to be treated somehow aggressive way, but they need to be, they are very communicative animals. Okay. And again, the handlers are responsible for the training of the horses, so they shouldn't forget about that. So this is the main, I think, this is the main item for them to think about their own security during their own work with the horses.
And it's their responsibility also, we have now the very professional handler. It's their responsibility to teach, to learn the new one who come in, because now it's very, it's become efficient to become handler quickly, and without any background, without any knowledge corrected to take care of the horses. So it's their responsibility also to participate for education for new one, for new handlers. The question is very important. The welfare, the security in general, it's very important.
The security is it's very important also for the judges that are in the middle of, the, of the ring anyway, judging the horses.
So. That's why we also allow to have a whip still in the main ring, because the handlers are leading the horse only on one leash. And for sure, some people could be againsting this, or they can against it. But it's also for kind of security of the handler and of all the other officials who are standing in the arena around the horse.
So please.
No, but for sure we can be talking about this item till morning. But this is probably a main question for handlers itself.
I will be asking around the handler what they think about this ball. And
yes.
For sure, you very watching good. Us, you will know.
We would be very happy to see their responses and their answers. No, maybe their ideas even.
Their concerns about this. And,
thank you so much for your time.
It's our pleasure.
It was a pleasure to know your vision about it.
Thank you very much for your invitation. It was a pleasure
Let's
for us.
Let's enjoy the show tomorrow.
We hope so.
Thank you. As always.